is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Sean in Canada. Hey, Sean, what's going on?
Hey, Tom, how's it going, brother?
It's going great, man. How you doing?
I'm a huge fan of the show. I just found out about you guys within the last month and a half.
Okay.
And I can't believe, I'm like, where did these guys come from?
How did you find out about us?
Sometimes I'll go in the search engine and try to find some market analysis.
Okay, man. Welcome to the Tiger family. Appreciate you growling and prowling with us, man.
Yeah, man. I really appreciate you guys, and I'm just excited to watch your bids. I get a lot out of them. I really love the intros you do and the excitement and the energy, and you guys are pretty special.
Well, we get a great network, man, and there's a lot of diversity, man, and we're really lucky. Thank you so much for calling, man.
Thanks, buddy.
Thanks, Sean. Have a great one. Have a safe
one. You too, bud.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Create the perfect relationship between you and your body. Treat your body with all love, honor, gratitude, and respect. When you make it a goal to adore your body and accept yourself completely, you're learning to have the perfect relationship with anyone else you are with. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 122, NASDAQ's down 13, S&P's down 7.5. Gold contract up $1.60, traded at $12.93 an ounce. Silver down 17 cents, $18.33 an ounce. Platinum down $6, $9.77 an ounce. Copper down 6.5 pennies at $2.52 a pound. Light sweet crude flat, $52.57 a barrel. Notes, 10-year note up 21 ticks, 126.18. 30-year bond is almost up 2 points, 155.11. They're both ABC structures on the way up. They took out a 4-month consolidation. Bottom line, the 10-year has just finished a 1-to-1 ABC structure on the way up. 30-year has about another point, 15.5 is the number. Big numbers out here. King dollar getting toasted and roasted. That's down 814 ticks, 99.380. King dollar's making its way down to its lowest swing point. Euro, the euro is trading at 107 to the U.S. dollar. The yen is at 108 to the U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world, in the world of the S&Ps. Let's take a look at them. What do you have? We are trading sideways in the S&P. You're down 78 cents. It's really a sideways move out here. You are doing 57 million shares. We did 68 yesterday. Bottom line is that you're building cars, folks, to get into this 231.61 swing low from the 27th of March. We go take a look at the Dow Industrials. Dow Industrials is the weaker indice out here. Now, the Dow Industrials hasn't been able to hold the lows of the first downdraft, which was on March 21st. That number is important. It's 20,653. It had tried to get over that since the 21st of March. Each and every time it gets up there, can't handle it. Bottom line, you're under it. What is that set up? That sets up a number going all the way down to 19,981. What's going to get intriguing here right after the close is this, is that inside the Dow Industrials today, putting the juice on the downside, is that you have Goldman Sachs and you have Johnson & Johnson. You know, the Dow's down $1.18. Now, out of the Dow being down $1.18, Goldman Sachs is putting 75 negative points into it. That's down $10.50. Johnson & Johnson is putting 29 negative points into it. So you can see both of those by themselves got 104 negative points. Into the positive, you have United Health putting 12 points, McDonald's putting 5. Bottom line, check it out. Okay, so now let's go over and take a look at it after the close. IBM is going to be coming out with numbers. Way IBM's trading, folks, it looks to me like IBM wants to get into this 161. We are trading at 170 right now. We'll see where that shakes. IBM also, bottom line, would put some heavy numbers into the Dow If it went down, heavy numbers into the Dow. If it went up. NASDAQ Composite. What do we have with the Composite out here? Composite is trading sideways. You're down 13 bucks. That's still a sideways move. We'll see how this Composite handles the lower swing point of 58.05 down to the 57.69 area. If we take a look at the NDX 100, what you have with the NDX 100 is this. Now, NDX 100 got to a price point today of 131.66. You've done 10 million shares. You're at 131.16. What that's all about, folks, is that the NDX tried to get to a higher high, got over the highs of last Friday, failed on price, failed on volume. NDX 100 wants to go south. And the number to keep your eye on in the NDX 100 is the lows of the same benchmark, the 21st. That's 129.73. Gold contract. What do we have with the gold contract? Gold contract, folks, is an ABC structure on the way up. It performed out here today. pretty amazing. The gold was down. Gold was down at 1280. Bottom line, rejected lower price. You're at 1294 right now. You have a confirmed ABC structure on the way up to 1307. I suspect we're going to get to the 1313 level. The 1313 level, folks, is the highs of November 2nd. And that's the election day, meaning the 9th, that's the benchmark in many of these indices. Well, we go over to the notes, the 10-year note. 10-year note took off like a rocket ship. You did 1.2 million shares, contracts rather. Bottom line is that you just finished a 1-to-1 ABC structure on the way up. And, you know, let me just look at this. So 125, 122. So you got 128 is game. That's how that's shaking out. And that's where I'm coming from that. That's because of the consolidation. That's going to be pretty intense, though, I can tell you that. The 10-year note right now is trading, is yielding 2.165. 30-year bond, what do you have with the 30-year? That took off like a rocket ship. This is up 2 points, 270,000 contracts. Now, this is at 155.13. That ABC structure, well, let me do this this way. So 159. So the ABC is 156.5. More than likely, we're going to see this go to 159. That's a big number. King dollar. What do we have with King dollar? King dollar just is getting basically taken apart out here today, folks. So we're down 800 ticks. You've done 25,000 contracts. We're at 99.375. Now, 99.335 is the highs of the low that was generated out here on the 27th of March. This is really important. The reason being is that we haven't touched the high yet. It doesn't look like to me we're going to get a rejection of price. So now what you're going to get, you're going to get a market that's going to open up tomorrow that has already got toasted, meaning the currency market. And this thing, baby, this thing wants to run right down into this 96.89 area. Big numbers. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials are down $1.20. Nasdaq's off 14. S&P's are down 7.5. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, 2x currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. The Dow right now is down 117. Nasdaq's off 12. S&Ps are on down six and a half. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Basil Chapman. And don't forget, folks, Basil's got an outstanding show right here every trading day, 11 to 12 Eastern Standard Time. He also has a great newsletter. It's called The Opening Call. And coming up Thursday night, this Thursday night, he's going to have a subscriber event. That event is taking place, folks, from 6 to 7:30 Eastern Standard Time. For all subscribers, now you can be a subscriber right now. You can test drive his newsletter 30 days absolutely free. That gets you a great newsletter, number one, for 30 days. Number two, it's going to get you into this event. And we're going to talk to our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, right now, and he can tell us what this event is all about. Basil Chapman, what's going on?
Hi, Tom. How are you?
Doing great, man. Yourself?
Very good. Thank you.
Yeah, so you had a heck of a marathon yesterday, huh?
It was. I didn't actually get to see all that much. I'm very close by, but yeah. I was busy here. But and at the same time, I did see a couple of things, and there were some really wonderful aspects to it. The South African for the third time came second within a hair of the wheelchair, and it was terrific to see because the person who won has won for 3 years. And before that, I'm formerly from South Africa, yeah. So I was interested. The South African had won for a long time. So, and it was so interesting. What we had Ugandan, a male and female winners. Right. And we had the same thing with, I think, was it Swedish? Was it a Swedish? Yeah, I think the bike and the woman were Swedish. So, yeah, this is very interesting. Or at least the winner was. So we've got some interesting things. And then there was the vet who was there with his prosthetic.
Yeah.
Did fantastic, holding the flag. I mean, it's quite incredible to see.
No doubt, it was really very
interesting. Beautiful day, too.
So, yeah. So market-wise, what do we have happening out here? Tell us about your workshop first.
So this is the timing for this workshop couldn't be better because what we've had since the 1st of March, this is after that speech that Trump gave,
okay.
A big spike up in the morning, and then we saw the reversal in gold, a whole bunch of things happened. And what's really important is that since this time, we've used up energy, but we really haven't broken down in price. And I keep looking at this now. For my subscribers, we've been short the Dow. We are short the Dow. We are short the S&P. We're short the QQQ. We're short the SMHs via those vehicles where you can buy the long side, but they are made up of short. They're already short all those instruments. So this is very important because it makes it very much easier for people who have never shorted before to actually say, you know, I'm a little cautious. I want to protect my portfolio. I want to do things. It's a very good way to do it. So I'll be talking about that. The other thing that I'll talk about is when we use up time and you don't use a price, then you've got to ask yourself, is there a relationship that we've seen before where there's a rotation going on? For instance, let me just show you something very quickly. General Electric here is up 21 cents today. It doesn't look great. Earnings coming out, I think, Friday. But it's a bounce, and it should be down. Instead, it's bouncing. So that's a good sign. This is my Dow Quartet Index, I call it. Of course, there's no real indexes. These are stocks that I've always followed. I put them together. IBM, not looking very good. Triple M, on the other hand, is holding very well. Used up time, and really, since its high of 193, has not broken down. It's at 190. And then the final one is UTX. UTX is actually holding, it looks quite good. If I was just looking at these stocks, I would say, hey, market's holding beautifully. But if I was looking at the volatility index, and these are things that I'm going to talk about, the volatility index up in the 14s, it was over 16 the other day, I'd be saying, wow, the general market must be down 5, 6, 7%. Not the case. So this, I think, is another instance of a rotational correction. And one of the things I'm looking at, and I'll be discussing in great detail, is in the monthly chart, you know, in the premise of the Chapman wave is to go to four higher peaks. And it doesn't matter what time frame. That's kind of the crux of the whole thing.
Yes.
Well, the Dow has gone to a leg D and probably is going to make a peak D. But that's in the monthly chart. However, the S&P is in leg C, almost certainly going to make a peak C. I didn't see what can get it above 2,400 before the end of the month. And that's positive. That means there should still be a D to come. If you look at the QQQ series, that is the NASDAQ 100, leg C. It still looks fine. It hasn't even made a peak C. It hasn't even shown a sign of a peak C. But the shorter term starts to look as if there's some vulnerability here, especially if you put it together with the SMHs, which led us up and seem to be leading us down because the SMHs says they've had the biggest decline. So what I'm going to be doing in this particular webinar is I'm going to be discussing the longer term. I'm going to be discussing what I think will be triggers, stocks that should move up with that particular move. I'll be discussing, there's a very interesting thing if I can just show you here. Look, yes, this is a chart. This is one of the charts that I'll be showing. This is the bank index, the KBF bank index versus the S&P. The S&P is in this dark red line.
Okay.
And this is the bank index. This is not up to date to today. It's a little bit lower. But you can see that there's been a fabulous correlation in direction. And here we are starting to have a dip in the S&P monthly chart, and we've got a very strong dip in the BKX. And if you put that together, you look at the SMHs, this is the SMH versus the S&P, it's the same thing. And what I've been discussing and saying to my subscribers, since we do have some long stocks that are acting very well, I've been saying we've got to be very selective here. We can't just be one-sided. We've got to be looking at both sides of the coin. But two things are going on. The TLT, which is the Lehman 20-year T-bond fund, has made what I call a propeller shaft to the upside. This is a very different pattern to the one that I call the stalk leg, where you'll see this oval yellow pattern. This is one that says there's a strong move happening. There was a sideways consolidation. Now you've got a one-to-one to the upside. Invariably, this is saying to us that yields are coming down. So this is the TLT. This is bonds. It essentially says that if this pattern continues as it's done and it breaks a key resistance, in this case, it went today just above the 200-period smooth moving average, then there can be a consolidation, but it should be a high-level consolidation. And that's different to the stalk leg, which says when it's complete, it's going to go all the way back into the body and even lower. So this is that yields should continue lower, that bonds should, at this particular point, are doing two things. It's a flight from equities some of the equities into the safety of stocks, into the safety of bonds. And that's something we hadn't seen for quite a while. So I think that this is a very important period. I think that the consolidation is going to continue a little longer. But at the same time, we're looking at specific areas that should work, and they're coming to focus. And until we get a low of substance, and I think that will be with the volatility index probably going into the high 20s, maybe the low 30s, I think that we're going chop, chop, chop to the downside with slightly lower lows and slightly lower highs at this particular period, and that's what I'll be discussing. And so folks, I think it's going to cover a lot.
And folks, you can come right over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see it right in the top of the carousel. It says Open Call Subscriber Webinar. Basil Chapman subscriber event Thursday, the 20th of April. It's going to go from 6 to 7:30. Now, remember, you just have to test drive his newsletter. You get it for 30 days. You get a great workshop. You get a great newsletter. And what also happens, folks, if you can't make it live, remember, we have some great technology that'll be archived on your page for a full 30 days. Basil, you have a great one, a safe one. Of course, we look forward to the program tomorrow.
Thank you very much, Tom. You too.
Thank you. You stay right there, folks. We're going to be coming right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow's down 109. NASDAQ is down 5. We're going to be right back.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. The Dow Industrials right now down 114. You get the NASDAQ off 9. S&Ps are off 2.5. And if we go take a look at this, gets it interesting, folks. So what I'm going to show you right here is that this is a Bloomberg chart of vanishing short sellers. And what the chart shows, it's pretty wild, actually. What it shows is that this is inside the SPY, the SPY, that at the end of March, so we're it's April 18th right now. At the end of March, this was the short interest inside the SPY was the lowest it had been since 2007. Now, what they have in here, they updated this today, that there was a more recent market data showed a slight uptick since then, but not much. Bottom line is that this is important in the context because guess what, folks? When things do pull back, that's when that interest goes, it normally is, it's a contrary type of deal, but it's normally dramatically lower. And the reason that you can get a fast downdraft is that no one has to cover their positions. And this is pretty intense, actually, because just looking at this, it looks like it's about 180 million shares shot. And then if we went back to, this is pretty intense, actually, if we went back to the beginning of 2015, you're talking about 400 million. And 2011, you're talking about, over 500 million. Yeah. So bottom line is that that's a good number to keep your eye on. And we'll see how the rest of this shakes out. Because what I do expect we're going to see after the market close out here, there's a couple highly volatile stocks. ISRG. So this is Intuitive Surgical. Intuitive Surgical is this baby can go up or down 20 or 30 points in a heartbeat. It's down $9.41 right now. It has some volume off the top, but this can get into 735 in a heartbeat. Let me see. I believe it's at highs right now. There it is. It's definitely at highs. I just put this back 20 years, and this is pretty amazing. Actually, if we just go from 2009, it was trading at $84, and this month we hit a high of 775. IBM, of course, is going to be another big one. LRCX, in the chip business, Lam Research is coming out right after the close also. And Lam Research is trading 127.44, and this has been a little rocket ship, big time. You know, this Lam Research, it was a one-way trip. Lam Research, September of 2015, stocks at 61, and one-way move. The way Lam looks to me is that the last time with any volume was 102, and right now we're at 127. And if you want to see when equities fall out of bed, folks, most of the time, and this is where it's really important with this price and volume when you're looking at it, is that for some reason they fall back to right where the last time is that they had any volume. It doesn't mean that they're going to hold there either, because if there's too much volume on the way back, they're going to blow that area out. Now, Cardinal Health, right now is down $9.50, big number. What does Cardinal do? You know, bottom line, Cardinal had made a high on the 14th of March, big number high. That high up there was 84. Goes sideways, closed last night at 81, and opens this morning at 72. Well, when you take a look at it, where is it open? It opens to the right. Last time you had any volume. Last time we had any volume on the upside was on the 7th of February. The low of that 7th of February was 74, the high is 79. Now, what you have happening here is that this is way too much volume, because what just has happened is that this little baby is not only taking this out, this is saying that now we get game down to the 68 area, which is pretty intense. Let's go to Chris in Montana. Hey, Chris, what's going on?
Not much. How are you doing today, Tom?
I'm doing great, man. Thanks for calling. Thanks for holding. Appreciate it.
Great. Thanks for taking my question. Hey, so I'm looking at this market, and ES is down a little bit. The RUT's down a little bit. The NQ is down a little bit. But bonds are up 2 points. What's going on? You think those big banks are just buying a bunch of bonds?
I don't think it's the big banks buying bonds.
Okay.
You know, people have been buying bonds for a long time. And, you know, the central banks across the world could be buying them, yeah. I mean, because what you have, technically, you know, their ABC structures on the way up. Fundamentally, you know, when you still take a look at our rates versus the rates around the world, well, guess what? You know, money crosses borders in 2 seconds. And if you're in France, they're getting 0.8% for a 10-year. Germany's getting 0.1%. Well, you want 2%? Guess what? All you have to do is go buy a 10-year treasury. And what happens, folks, in the larger context with whether they're central banks, whether they're large pension funds, whether they're trust, is that what they want to do is, let's picture that you're a large trust, and the trust would be, you know, you have a large union, and you know that you have so many people that you have to pay off over the course of so many years. Well, what they do is that they take their duration, and they take their the other side of the balance sheet is what they got to pay off. And, you know, that's what they do. And the bottom line is that they have plenty of choices to make. And the choice is, do you want to get 1%? Do you want to get 2.5%? Now, what they do have to do is that they have to also understand, saying, if I'm taking my euro and I'm going to put it in U.S. dollars, is the currency going to stay strong too? But, you know, the bottom line is that bonds look to me like they're going to go a lot higher. So.
Okay. Well, I appreciate your insight, Tom. Thank you. Have a great day.
Okay. Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. And we do look at these rates, folks. This is, so you have the 10-year right now is at 2.172. When we look at this in the last 3 months, that's the lowest it's been in the last 3 months. We put this in 6 months, and you're going to see it's just shy of about the middle. So the last 6 months, the low has been 1.735. The high is 2.626. You can see that we're quite a way away from the high. And yeah, is it deviant? Yeah, it absolutely is deviant, folks, because when we know that the Fed is going up on short-term rates, you know, bottom line, that's the short-term, the very short-term, because that's bank-to-bank. Most of the time when that happens, though, they can move the whole curve. They have not been able to move the curve. And it looks to me, and fundamentally that makes sense why they couldn't move the curve, because you have rates so low across the whole world. That's the first part. The second part is actually easier. The second part is that this market has had an great run up for 7 years. And I can just see people saying, hey, I made the run. I got the run. I got my money. I want to keep my money. And if you're happy with that, guess what? 2% is good because you have your cash. Though, if we go over to Goldman Sachs, and you know, Goldman Sachs has been the canary in the coal mine. This is was a major failure at its 2007 high. Failed on price, failed on volume. You know, we 250 comes off that number, with big volume. That's down $10.50 today. Monster volume. This thing's not done yet. We traded to 213. It looks to me like the 204 is the number. And 204, folks, guess what? Brings you right back to November 10th and November 11th. So it's pretty intense. That's election day. That's where this market wants to go. And if the S&P goes there, that's a long way down, the S&P. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials right now are down 103. NASDAQ's off 5. S&P's are down 5. No, NASDAQ is, down 5. S&P's are down 5. Going to be right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video, giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
With over $56 million in cash and over $66 million in working capital, Great Panther Silver is positioned as a company with a solid foundation and poised for growth. While completely unhedged to the price of silver, Great Panther retains 100% ownership in two producing mines in Mexico, which is the top silver producing country in the world, along with future potential production in Peru. Great Panther is highly leveraged to the price of silver, and after a great year of performance in 2016, Great Panther Silver has a strong outlook for 2017 as well. With good liquidity in trading and strong fundamentals on the balance sheet, while remaining completely unhedged to the price of gold and silver, now is a perfect time to take a closer look at this equity. If you'd like to find out more about Great Panther Silver, then go to greatpanther.com or check them out on the NYSE Market, symbol GPL, or the TSX, symbol GPR. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. The Dow right now is down 101. Nasdaq's down 4. S&Ps are down 4.5. We take a look at some of the higher volume stocks in this low volume market out here today. This is what you have. You have Regions Financial is down 57 cents. GE is up 20. You have Wells Fargo down 16. Netflix is down 372. They come out with numbers last night. You have Freeport MacMoran down 27. Let's go over and take a look at FCX first. So FCX, yeah, this baby's still in trouble. So FCX is down off a high of 1665. You're 1248. That's going to come all the way back to where the strength started from, which is a 1124 on the, on the 8th of November. And, you know, the bottom line is that I know Trump's speaking right now, and he's saying that an infrastructure bill is going to be coming up. Well, guess what? It's too late for U.S. Steel. Bottom line, U.S. Steel had run from $18 on the 3rd of November, the day of the election. It gapped up to 25. It ends up making a high at 41 on the 21st of February, and now you're trading at 28.78. And this baby broke down and broke down with volume. This thing is going to make its way back all the way back to 21. If you take a look at another steel company, which is AKS, what you're going to have, AKS has actually already made it back to that level. AKS is, went from a price point of $11.11. to 632, and that gap, the top of the gap is 614. You want to see something? This is crazy. So the top of the gap is 614. We hit 615 today. Bottom line, infrastructure bill may come, but the way the market is looking at it right now, it's not going to be here for a long period of time. We're going to take a look at the XAU, the HUI. This is what you have happening in the XAU. It traded down to a low today of 87.81, rejected that level. You're at 89.07 right now, and this is in a confirmed ABC structure up into the 91 to 92 area. I expect what you're going to see here, though, this will probably run to that 97, which is the February 8th high, swing high. You get over, and we look at the Gold Bugs Index, the HUI. What you have inside the HUI right now, that came down to 208.94, rejected lower price. This is a confirmed ABC structure on the way up to 219. Now, it's going to get interesting here, folks, is this. What we've done inside the HUI and the XAU is that we've had one confirmed ABC structure on the way up. If, in fact, we may have just set up another one, and it's going to be amazing if we did, because if we just set up another one, let me see how this world works. You're talking $11, which would get you to $11, yeah, 208, 220. Yeah, that makes sense. And 222 is that high. Yeah, these things, they're both shooting for the high of February as well as November. That's how this baby is set up at this particular point. When you do take a look at the market out here today, it gets really interesting in the context of, you do have the dollar that's smoked. Gold is only up 90 cents. Now, it came back a huge amount. The GDX is down 12 cents. That also, though, just may have set up another ABC structure on the way up. It's already in one ABC. And if, in fact, we did, it's 22.53. Oh, it's a good one. It's 2.20, which would get you 24.26.20. Yep, the numbers go. So 26.20 would be the ABC up, and 26.20 inside the GDX would get you up and over the highs of both November and October. I mean, November and February. And that's going to be a big number, because what we have had is that the peso has already, well, watch this. If you want to see something, this is just so ironic that it's the peso that is the first one that figured out. Bottom line is that there's a lot of talk, but there's not much action. The peso, folks, okay, election day was $18.30. When Trump got elected, they figured Mexico was toast. It went up to 22 pesos to one U.S. dollar. It's already back to 18.50. That was the first currency that actually came all the way back down. The yen, we go over to the yen. It's happening inside the yen right now. The yen is trading at 108.49. That had started off at 104.63. Actually, one second. No, that started off at 105. 105.16. It goes all the way up to 118. Guess what? 108.49. And there's that baby, bottom line. There's not much, because we went up so fast, there's nothing to stop it from coming down just as quick. And that's how that has been operating in a big way. Over in Europe, out here, Europe today, Europe had a tough day out here. Europe, you had the FTSE down 2.5%. The CAT was off 1.5%. The DAX was off 0.9%. We take a look at that FTSE, and this is important. Yes, they got Brexit happening. They are going to have Theresa May called a new election so she could get support in order to get the Brexit going. Well, what happened is that in the matter of an hour and a half, the FTSE gave back everything to January 3rd. It's been a monster consolidation. And guess what? Hour and a half, it just took it all. Just like that. And I don't have the volume yet, but I went over and looked at some of these. Individually, I have the volume on these equities. And this is going to have monster volume. This is going to be, it's going to blow out this whole consolidation with volume. And that's saying that the FTSE wants to run back to the 6990 number. And 6990 number is also the number where the FTSE also took off topside. And what you want to wrap your head around is that you're not going to have the FTSE down 2.5%, nor the DAX down, let me get you the numbers on the DAX here. The DAX, we just went down 108, not that that's a lot, but you're not going to have those kind of numbers. Yeah, we're down 0.9%, and have our markets basically go up or hang tough. That's just, you know, you got to, my take here is we got a little delayed reaction happening, which would be totally the way that markets like to work. The reason being, folks, okay, is that if this is a slow roll, that's what it looks like to me. What happens with a slow roll is this. You just, on a very subtle basis, you try to make a high, you can't do it. We've been trying to get through the downdraft of the 21st of March for a full month. Well, we haven't made it. That's the slow roll. Then what ends up happening, if you take a horseshoe and just turn it upside down, when you get to the right-hand side of that horseshoe, just down a little, then what ends up happening, you get that fast downdraft. And once that fast downdraft comes in, then that locomotive is going. And in the case of the S&P, this is pretty intense, because as I just brought you through the aspect of where the currencies are going, where gold is going, where, well, guess what? We're at 234. The S&P would be at 212. That's a big number. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. 877-927-6648. Dow is down 99. NASDAQ is off 3. S&P's are down 5. We're going to be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. And I want to thank our man Duffy in the den. So hey, check this out, folks. And this is what's really important to understand what the net asset value is of anything ETF when you're buying it. So the Deutsche Bank Gold Double Shot ETN. So ETN's exchange-traded note, right? Exchange-traded note issued in the U.S. by Deutsche Bank. The notes will provide investors with a cash payment at the scheduled maturity or early redemption based on the double or inverse performance of the underlying index plus monthly T-bill index. Now, let me show you something. So this is shot gold, folks, okay? Right now, this is up 53 cents. Well, if we go over to the gold contract and we take a look at the gold contract, what you're going to see is that the gold contract right now is flat. Okay, so it's like, okay, what the heck is going on with the DZZ? So let me show you what's happening here. So the net asset value, this is trading at 602. The net asset value is 539. The bottom line, folks, if you own this, I'd sell it, like in a heartbeat. And I wouldn't short this, because what's going on is that, let me show you something else here that is pretty wild. We did 1.7 million shares here. There's only 4.9 million shares outstanding in this exchange-traded note. There's trouble in paradise in this note, whatever is happening out here today. This is you do not want to be trading ETFs if they can't stay near their net asset value. So here, I'll bring you over to the Nugget for a second. So the Nugget's trading at 1090. If you're watching at Bloomberg, this is 1090, net asset value. Trading right at the net asset value. Now, we're talking about JNUG because what has happened is with JNUG is that the market vectors, it's going to change. They announced they are going to change their amended prospectus. Well, here, so let me show you what's happened here. So JNUG is trading at 643. The net asset value is 634. So bottom line is that is trading over it. It's important to understand how these things trade. What will happen with JNUG, so if we go to GDXJ, you're going to see this is the Market Vectors Junior Gold. They have announced that they are going to amend their guide on May 31st, and that is going to be applicable as of June 17th. So what the direction share did immediately is that they said, okay, we're not going to create anymore until we find out what is going to go inside of the Market Vectors Junior Gold Miners Trust. What I expect we're going to see is this, folks. They're going to have to make it bigger. These are so popular that they don't have, and the juniors, they don't have enough market cap inside there for the amount of people that actually want to trade it. That's what's going on. Because when you read through this site, I was reading through the site last night as to what they don't tell you what they're going to do. What they tell you is that they tell you the new parameters. And it seems that when you're reading what the new parameters are, is that they're bringing down and expanding the asset of who will be able to actually get in the GDXJ. Now, the cool thing is here, so check this out. This is where this is going to get, we can give all the tigers and tigresses some homework here. Because if you can figure out, on a probability basis, who is going to get in there, those equities, folks, are going to get some buying power. Because the bottom line is that the second that they announce that they're going to be in the indice, guess what? They're going to buy it. And, you know, I mean, it's pretty dramatic, too, because when you do look at the JNUG, folks, okay, has a market cap of $1.09 billion. The GDXJ has a market cap of $5.25 billion. So you can see what's happening, that they actually own approximately 15.7% of it. You know, so you can see supply and demand curve, it's where it's at. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming back. We've got a lot of numbers after the close today. Dow Industrials down 109. NASDAQ is off 5. S&Ps are down 6. We're going to be right back.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.
The following
is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Nick in Tampa. Hey, Nick, what's going on?
Tom O'Brien, it is an absolute pleasure.
Thanks so much, man. We appreciate you calling.
No problem. Dude, I've been listening to your show for about 2 years now, and it has just been wonderful. I listen to you, Basil, Andy. You guys do an amazing job.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling out here with us.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. So make it a great night, folks. Cultivate wisdom. You don't have to accumulate knowledge to become wise. Anyone can become wise. When you become wise, you respect your body, you respect your mind, and you respect your soul. When you become wise, your life is controlled by your heart, not your head. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials down 113, NASDAQ down 7, S&P's down 7.5, gold contract flat at $1,291.40, silver down 22 cents, $18.28 an ounce, platinum down $8.50 at $9.75 an ounce, copper down 6.5 pennies at $2.52 a pound, light sweet crude flat, $52.62 a barrel. Notes. Notes and bonds, folks, pretty amazing what they did out here today. They've been going up, but you talk about a push. We had the 10-year note up 19 ticks, 126.16. 30-year bond up one full point plus 20 ticks, 155.03. Bottom line, they're both one higher price. The 10-year finished an ABC structure on the way up. 30-year looks like it's going to go up to the 158 area. The 156.5 is the ABC structure, 1-to-1. Right now, you have the 10-year yield at 2.175. Pretty amazing. King dollar. What do we have with King dollar? King dollar, folks, trading at a price point right now of 99.410. King dollar came down with wide price spread, accelerated volume. You're down 784 ticks. You're trading at a price point of 99.410. 99.335 is the high of the low that was out here on the 27th. And bottom line, it looks like to me like it's going to slice and dice this baby. There's, you know, we'll see how it hits it. You know, King Dollar wants to trade down to this 95 area. When you take King Dollar, now this is where this gets really intriguing, folks. If you take King Dollar and you put this on a long-term chart, get a better idea of where we've been, what you're going to see is, you know, bottom line is that we were in a consolidation to break out, which we did, and that consolidation lasted from March of 2015 to November of 2016. You broke out of it. We were outside of it for two full months. We were teetering for the next 3 months. And now we broke back inside it. And right now, you got a decisive break inside it because the number of the break back inside is 100.600. Now what that sets up is a run to the lower end of this consolidation. And the lower end of that consolidation is 91.880. So we'll see where this whole thing is going to shake out, but it's pretty intense. Gold contract. What do we have with the gold contract? Gold contract, folks, is an ABC structure on the way up. It rejected lower price today. It got to a price point of 1280. It closed out at 1291.20. Your ABC structure is 1307. That's the price projection. Your swing high from November 4th is 1317. Looks to me like 1317 is going to be on the agenda here. Silver, we take a look at the silver market. Silver also rejected lower price, and they took silver apart, man. There's no doubt. They took silver from a price point yesterday. We closed at silver at 1850. They took silver down at 1806, rejected that level, closed at 1827. Bottom line, silver wants to make the run this for this $19.06, which is the high of the of November 9th. That's the way this whole thing seems to be shaking out right now. And the 30-year, we go over to the 30-year. You take a look at the 30-year, what you have inside the 30-year. 30-year right now, you're up $1.55. Bottom line, this has wide price spread, volume, all of the above. We get in, we take a look at the SPY, and this is where it's going to get really interesting. So the SPY out here today was flat, folks. It was down 70 cents, but realistically flat. 79 million shares. It closed out at 233.87. And what you're going to see, it's trading at 233.79 right now, so it's down another 10 cents. What that's going to be all about is IBM just come out with numbers. IBM closed it at 170. That's trading at 164. Bottom line is that IBM, their estimate was 235. They came in at 238. Their revenue estimate was $18.4 billion. Their revenue came in at $18.2 billion. Their bottom line is that they have continually... their revenue continually has gone down. IBM looks like it's a nice ABC structure on the way down set up. I suspect we're going to get down to this 161 area. 161 area. Now, this is what's really cool about how all these markets are setting up. 161, guess where it is, folks? That's going to be November 10th. That's the uplift that happened at the election. That whole uplift, folks, each and every indice is going back into where that whole thing started. And if the SPY does that, here, let me just give you the number on the cash S&P, because it's a big number. Right now, the cash S&P is trading at 2343. We started out on the, is the ninth right there. You're talking about 2125. So that would be, that'd be a heads up in a big way, because we haven't had those types of moves. What we have had overseas today that had that type of move, FTSE 100 was down 2.4%. The CAC was down 1.5%. You had the DAX down 0.9%. ISRG, let's see if Intuitive Surgical is out yet. It is. Oh, my God. Check this out. So Intuitive Surgical closed at 7.59. That's trading at 7.81. And this is a stock that can go up $20 or $30 in a heartbeat, and it just went up $30. In fact, that would be a new high. Yeah, it's going to be a new high. So let's see what they have to say. Intuitive Surgical, the estimate, earnings per share estimate was $4.95. They made $5.09. Their revenue estimate was $6.65. They took in $6.74. That's what markets want to see. They want to see the bottom line go up and the top line go up, and that's exactly what you have with Intuitive Surgical. LRCX, Lam Research, let's see if that come out yet. Lam Research closed at 127.43. That's trading at 130.86. So that's up $3. And this estimate, earnings per share, was 257. They made 280. Gross revenue, earnings estimate was 2.13 billion. They took in 2.15 billion. So this also is going to end up at a new all-time high. Let's see. Because the all-time high is 130 right now. 130.13. That's trading 131. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow finished down 113. NASDAQ off 7. S&P's down 7.5. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. We had the Dow finished down 113, NASDAQ down 7.5, S&P's off 7. And as we do each and every Tuesday and Thursday, let's go over to our man, Mr. Andy Hecht. And don't forget, folks, Andy's got a great program right here on TFNN every Tuesday and Thursday, 5 to 6 Eastern Standard Time. And remember, no matter where you are right now, if you happen to be listening in your car radio, remember that you can get us right on your cell phone. You go to TFNN.com. And as you go there, you know, on the right-hand side, you're going to see hit this button and whatever, it will say watch Target TV on your mobile device, and our servers will know exactly what type of device you're on, and Target TV will come right up, folks, and you'll get some great HD quality video as well as audio. Andy's also got a great newsletter. It's called the Technomento Commodity Report. Now, the way you test drive that, you come over to our website at TFNN. You go to newsletters, you go to trading newsletters. You can test drive that 30 days absolutely free. And he's going to be coming out with a new one. It's a beautiful thing. Andy Hecht, what's going on?
Hey, how are you? Hit that button. Watch Tiger TV.
It's, I'll tell you, man, you know what I was doing? I had to go a meeting out of the office today, folks, right? And that's exactly what I did, is I hit that button.
You hit that button.
I hit that button, man, and it was a beautiful thing.
It is.
Folks, just so you know, it's really different in the car, too, because, I mean, the way cars are loaded right now, and it went just like nothing. It was really cool.
But hey, but watch the road, you know?
Yeah. No, totally.
Anyway, you know, I never understood that. You see all these cars now with all these video displays and stuff. You know,
I know.
It's like, whoa, it kind of scares me. It's great for passengers, but for the drivers, you know.
It is. It's definitely dangerous. There's no doubt about it, man.
It is. Yeah. So, you know, very interesting, Tom. The industrial commodities have been taking it on the chin.
Yeah. That's because they all, infrastructure, they all went up. U.S. Steel's getting killed. They're all getting killed,
yes,
man.
Yes. And what happened is, you know, after Congress wasn't able to do anything with healthcare, they're all saying, got to be careful here. Iron ore down 30% since March.
Right.
Copper taking a nosedive, down 7 cents today.
Yeah, I know.
We got base metals, every single base metal, that's copper, aluminum, nickel, lead, zinc, tin, all lower than their Q1 closing prices. So, you know, I wonder if this isn't a buying opportunity in these commodities. The one thing that is holding in there is the Baltic Dry Index, which tells me that there are consumers buying the dip here, and that consumer is probably China.
Yeah.
So, you know, interesting going on there. And big volatility in the currency markets ahead. Today, the Prime Minister of Great Britain told us that she's going to hold snap elections, which, by the way, that got the pound up to around 129 and change. That could be good news for cocoa.
Okay.
That could be a relief rally coming in the cocoa market, so keep your eye on that one. But I'll tell you, all bets are off this weekend. You know, we're going to see a lot of currency volatility Friday going into this French election. No question about
right,
that.
Right, so the election's Sunday, right? And,
yeah.
And so the Le Pen's supposed to be one of the two. That's what they're figuring, right?
Right, right.
And so the question is going to be, who is the second one, folks? And then there's going to be a runoff after that. And
right, and it's going to be status quo versus populism, nationalism. And then,
I don't
know.
It says that, is it status quo or is it the left versus the right? I guess the left is getting, you know, the far left and far right. It's almost like you got, you know.
Well, you know, but Europe is far left anyway. So I would put the far left closer to the status quo than Le Pen, certainly.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, sure.
So we'll see what happens. I mean, chances are you're not going to find out who the next leader of France is on Sunday. But, you know, with Le Pen, it depends. If she has a very strong showing, you know, the euro could get whacked on Monday.
Yeah. You know? Oh, it'll be intriguing watching this whole thing shake out, man. You know?
And meanwhile, here, our bonds, man, they're breaking to the upside, huh?
Oh, yeah, big time.
Oh, that's a big, big, strong bonds, big, weak dollar.
And that, you know, that when I look at that euro looks to me like it's going back to 109, you know, so.
Oh, it looks to me like 110. Yeah. Same thing. It does. But, you know, if Le Pen gets a lot of votes, that could slow it down a little bit. Could slow it down.
Yeah, because the theory, I believe, folks, is that if Le Pen gets it, she wants out of the European Union, right?
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
Right,
and that's the second biggest economy in Europe, Germany. And, you know, with Britain gone, with UK gone, if France were to leave, you know, I don't know who they're going to start governing in Brussels and Frankfurt, but it's going to change a lot. It's going to take a lot of the wind out of that EU sail.
Totally.
But it also could portend big changes in Germany. You know, you never know. They're going to the polls in a couple of months, too. So, you know, going to be interesting weekend. So let's turn our attention here to the energy commodities, if you would. Take a look at crude oil. Crude oil looks like it's turning south, going back to that sweet, bless you, that
Thank
sweet
you.
Spot over at $50 a barrel. The product prices have been weakening. Let me put up a crack spread chart here in gasoline. You could see that's turned lower. And that was one of the reasons that I like crude oil when it was down at $47.
Okay.
And it's one of the reasons I don't like it here at $53 a barrel. You know, so that's turning south. And the heating oil crack is also turning south. Let me put that one up for a minute.
So, can we just go through this for a second? I just want
sure.
Okay. The last one you had, we just went from 19 to what price?
The RBOB gasoline. The RBOB gasoline went from,
of 21 to 19. I see. Okay, cool.
Yep. On to 19. So that's weakness in products.
Yep.
And the heating oil has gone from 1635 down to 1565. That's weakness. You know, it's just weakness in the sector. And this translates to the oil demand, and oil is turning here. I think it heads back to 50.
Yeah.
Hey, maybe we go a little lower, maybe we don't. You know, 50's a sweet spot for me. I've been saying that for weeks now.
Yes.
Looking at natural gas, that one looks like it's turning south too, looking like it's going to test the $3 per MMBTU level here, which is not a surprise considering that, you know, we have high levels of inventories. We're in injection season. There's not a lot of heating demand now. It's baseball season, you know?
Yeah.
You know? So that one looks like it's going down. And then the mother of all commodities here, MOAC. Mother of all commodities is gold, no question. Gold is the fearmonger. It's the Korean, Chinese commodity. It's the Syrian, Russian commodity. And it's telling us what a mess we are in the world. And, you know, I don't think it's going to be long before we see 1300 plus.
Yeah, well, I agree. I mean, today was a big day, you know.
Gold has had plenty
of big days, but, you know, you wouldn't know it looking at it. It's only flat, folks, okay? But let me tell you, it was down to 1280, And it wasn't being sold on conviction, though. That's what was really interesting. You know, even when it was down, it's like, okay, you're down $10. Is that all you can do?
Yeah, but I think people got scared because they saw silver coming off. They saw platinum coming off. You know, gold's the only one that's, like, doing well today. The rest of them are under some pressure here. But, you know, gold above 1,300, they'll all turn around and come back as well, as we saw a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah, I want to just look at this for a second. Okay, so this is interesting. Look at this. I don't use these folks, but I was just curious. I put these moving averages up, and it's over all the moving averages now. You know, I mean,
gold is, yeah.
3 days ago, yeah. You broke over the 200-day moving average.
I tell you, Tom, I think we get 1340 pretty easily here.
Yeah, I listen, man, I can dig that.
Yeah, yeah.
I think. You stay right there, all right?
Sure.
Andy and I are coming right back, folks. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow finished down 113. NASDAQ off 7. S&P down 7.5. We're going to be right back.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
TFNN has put together the finest live programming lineup each trading day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected financial minds in the nation to educate traders and investors. On Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, we broadcast 9 hours a day starting at 8 a.m. as John Logan kicks us off each trading day with the Global Market Pulse. Tuesdays and Thursdays, we broadcast 11 hours. Get an early and healthy start to your day as Nico and Paige bring you Living a Primal Lifestyle. Then catch Andy Hecht at 5 p.m. with the Commodities Hour. Following the Tom O'Brien Show, Mondays and Fridays, catch live trading on the Nadex platform with host Tom and Tommy O'Brien, along with Gerald Martin on the Bull Bear Binary Option Hour. See the TFNN program lineup via the link on the front page of TFNN.com to get a complete overview of our TFNN shows and hosts, and keep TFNN's Tiger TV tuned in on your mobile device, PC, or Mac for the latest financial news and information throughout the broadcasting day. TFNN, educating investors. This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Andy Heck, Tom O'Brien, we do appreciate your growling and prowling with us out here. You know, this is pretty wild. So, Andy, we got a bunch of numbers coming out. Yahoo just come out. Check this out. This is pretty. Yahoo's revenue jumped 22% in the first quarter.
Wow.
I don't know if they were looking for that, man, but that's pretty intense.
That's big.
That's big, man. So the estimate was 14 cents. Bottom line, they made 66 cents. Big number.
That's a big number.
It is. ISRG, Intuitive Surgical. You want to see a rocket ship, folks? That closed at 759. That's trading at 788. LRCX, Lam Research, that closed at 127. That's trading at 127. IBM is toasted, roasted. IBM closed at 170. That's trading 164. Now, what you have, folks, is that that S&P is going to take some heat. Intuitive Surgical will save it a bit, but IBM is going to put some juice into that baby.
And IBM, Goldman Sachs certainly put some juice into it today.
Totally, man.
Yeah.
Goldman Sachs, folks, was down 1067, 12 million shares traded, 215, and
I think it's pretty funny how I listened to a lot of the commentators today talking about, oh, maybe it's because Gary Cohn left.
Yeah.
No, I thought that was pretty funny.
I know, and in fact, I think I take a little bit longer to look at this, how this shakes out. But I believe, yeah, I got to do it first before I tell you what's good. Not tell you, I just want to make sure I get the right info. But there's been insiders that have been selling Goldman, too. So
Yes. Well, I mean, look at how high that stock has rallied.
Oh, sure. Right.
I mean, that's, you know, I'm sure Buffett's selling that stock. That you got to take profits.
PhDC. Let me just see.
Big number.
I'll be able to pull this up in a second. As to the largest holders. Okay, so let me do it this way. So you get Fidelity's the largest holder right now. No, not the largest holder. State Street. One second. Largest changes I'm looking for. Oh, this is funny. So whatever Goldman Sachs, is this their own? This is going to be pretty wild, folks. Let me pull this up. Goldman Sachs share. Oh, there you go. So they have Goldman Sachs shareholder agreement, right? The agent, they're they're selling. They've been selling since January 24th.
Yeah, what's the price to earnings ratio on GS now?
It is 19. That's still big.
That's big for a financial institution.
Right.
It's very big.
Right. You're paying $19 for $1 of earnings, and that's
19 times earnings.
That's at 215, folks. This updates automatically all day long. So that's at $215.
Right. So let's compare that to J.P. Morgan's.
J.P. Morgan. Oh wow, that's only at 6.
There you go. That's the intense reason. That's why you got to take profits.
Wow.
You know, yeah. I mean, it's pretty clear.
That is intense.
Hey, so hockey season, did you, by any chance, I know this has nothing to do with commodities, but I got to ask you, did you see that hockey game, that Blackhawks game last night?
I didn't.
And my heart goes out to our friends in Chicago at Nadex and at TD Ameritrade and all, because, you know, the Blackhawks went into the game down 2-0, really surprised by Nashville.
Okay.
And then they were up 2-0. Going into the third period.
Yeah.
And they lost in overtime.
Wow.
Oh, it was unbelievable. I mean, oh, such an upset.
That's
my
wicked,
God.
Man.
I was thinking about all those guys. I'm like, oh, I know they're diehard Cubs fans.
I was watching hockey all Saturday and all Sunday. I just forgot about it last night.
Yeah, good games. I mean, a lot of overtime. I love playoff hockey.
Different ball game, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a different sport. You know what? And Tom, I'm excited for the end of the season because we're getting a team here in Vegas next year.
Yeah,
the
I know.
The Golden Knights. We're getting the Golden Knights.
Oh, that's a good name. I like that.
Yeah. So the next time you come into town, we'll be able to catch a hockey game.
The Golden Knights. Now, who's Addison who got the team? Who got the team?
No, it's another guy. I forget his name.
Okay.
Addison is involved in the T-Mobile Center, and he's involved in building the stadium that the Raiders are going to come to.
I see. Okay.
But hockey. Listen, this place is swelled. We have over 2 million people. We have enough people now to support a franchise.
Oh, definitely. Not only that. What also happens is that I'd say there's a lot of sport fans in Vegas. I mean. Period, right? Yeah.
Most people are sports fans.
Right.
It's a huge sports town. And you know what? It's going to draw people in because people say, hey, my team is playing in Vegas. What a perfect excuse to go.
Oh, it is. It is.
Right.
It is.
Right. Absolutely. So it'll bring fans more than other cities, I think.
And, well, you know what's so cool? It's just another thing to do besides gambling. You know, which is great for the city.
Exactly. And you can walk from the strip to the T-Mobile Center.
Oh, you can.
It's right. I think it's right behind Caesars.
Oh, that's pretty cool. Okay.
Caesars or Bellagio. It's right there. I mean, you could walk. It's amazing. So that's a really good thing, you know?
That is huge, man.
Yeah.
That is huge.
It's going to be. So I'm excited because I've always been a big hockey fan. I'm a Ranger fan, of course. Sure. I know you're a Bruins and a Tampa fan. So I'll be a Rangers and a 51s fan and a Golden Knights fan.
I like that.
Yeah, it'll be good. It'll be good. So otherwise, I'm expecting a lot of volatility across all asset classes here coming into this French election. I guess North Korea is on the back burner, but that should find its way to the front burner again real soon because I don't think that guy's backing down anytime soon. Syria and Russia continue to be, you know, a hot button issue, and gold is the mother of all commodities here, and I love its path of least resistance higher here. You know, I think it's only a matter of time before silver catches a bid, too.
Well, we know how cycle the silver market is. You can wake
exactly.
up, folks,
cycle.
And silver
Perfect.
Is like up a buck. Well, you know what's intriguing? Like, I have all the commodities up right now. I suspect this weak dollar, one of these days, folks, we're going to pull this thing up, and these are all going to be green. Because if this dollar keeps going down, these commodities are going to catch a bid. You know.
Oh, they're going to catch a big bid. And it's not just, by the way, it's not just the metals. You're going to see it in the agricultural.
No, that's my point. No, that's what I had up. It's everything. Yeah. Exactly. That's what's so Absolutely. Cool about the aspect of really understanding commodities, too, folks. They're priced in U.S. dollars. And, you know, bottom line is that if the dollar's going down, it makes it cheaper to export everything, you know? So.
Right. Absolutely. It's going to make our products more valuable on the world scene. No question about it. So. Gonna be a wild. I think we're gonna have one of the wilder Fridays this year. This Friday.
No, that would make sense. People are gonna be. They're gonna after the Brexit, after Trump. You know, people are gonna be saying, okay, you know, where are we going here with this whole deal?
You know? Like the polls, man. I don't even. You know, I hear the polls. I kind of laugh now.
Yeah, you should laugh anyway. I know. I agree.
It's kind of a joke. It's like, because I don't think people tell the truth when they get polled. I really don't.
Well, I picked up something. What happens, folks, is that because we have to sell advertising, and I've been doing this a long time, Arbitron, it always blew my mind how Arbitron can get away, and these large agencies can get away with basically murder. And they're telling people how many people are listening to the station. It's arbitrary. That's what it comes down to. And if you ever realize just how many books they used to send out, they control billions of dollars, they send out hardly any books. So it's like, you know what?
Yeah.
You know, and I think that's same with polling. I mean, how many people they poll, right? You know.
Yeah.
Okay, man. Well, listen, we look forward to the show, 5:00.
Thanks, buddy.
20 minutes. Beautiful day.
I'll be there.
Thanks, man. Stay right there, folks. We're coming right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video, giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Take your phone calls
now.
Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow finished down 113. NASDAQ off 7. S&P's down 7.5. You know, I'll tell you, when you're talking gold, you know what's going to be interesting here, folks? The bottom line is that, yeah, I got to read this for you because we're in a day of age that you better be a technical trader, because I'm telling you, fundamentally, it's a tough time believing anything. So this just come across the tape. We were just talking about Korea. We were talking, well, here, I'll just read it for you. So this is a total mind blower. Aircraft carrier wasn't sailing to deter North Korea as the United States suggested. Now, this is coming right out of our own military. This is amazing. As worries deepened last week about whether North Korea would conduct a missile test, the White House declared that ordering an American aircraft carrier into the Sea of Japan would send a powerful deterrent signal and give President Trump more options in responding to the North's provocative behavior. The problem was the carrier, the Carl Vinson, and four other warships in the strike first that were at that very moment sailing in the opposite direction and to take part in joint exercises with the Australian Navy in the Indian Ocean. So check this out. 3,500 miles away from the Korean Peninsula. The White House official said on Tuesday they were relying on guidance from the Defense Department. Officials there described a glitch-ridden sequence. This is like so dysfunctional, it's over the top. Of events from premature announcement of the deployment of the military's Pacific Command to erroneous explanation by Defense Secretary Jim Mattis, all of which perpetrated the false narrative that the American Armageddon was racing toward the waters off North Korea. They were 3,500 miles away. In fact, they're still not there, folks. By the time the White House was asked about the Carl Vinson on April 11th, its imminent arrival had been emblazed on the front pages across East Asia, fanning fears that Trump was considering a preemptive military strike. But guess what? They were still in Australia. It was portrayed as further evidence of the president's muscular style 2 days after he ordered a missile strike on Syria. The saga of the wayward carrier might never have come to light had the Navy not posted a photograph yesterday of the Carl Vinson sailing through the Sunda Strait, which separates the Indonesian island of Java and Sumatra. The picture was taken on Saturday, 4 days after the White House press secretary, Sean Spicer, described its mission in the Sea of Japan. That's right. Just ask Spicer anything. The ships in Sumatra and supposedly supposed to be in the Sea of Japan. Anyway, bottom line, you know what, folks? I think you better really start understanding technical analysis, because fundamental analysis and technical analysis, you're both looking backwards. Fundamental analysis, you're believing what you're told. Technical analysis, you're trying to decipher where the supply and demand curve is, you know? And this day and age, that says quite a bit right there. That statement right there is so far over the top, it's unbelievable. Because as we all know, that was in the headlines everywhere, that the ships are going to Korea when, in fact, they were 3,500 miles away. I don't know how they're going to spin this one, man. This is going to be, like, just an amazing spin. I mean, I'm trying to figure out, are they that deviant that they're just going to lie and figure they're never going to get caught, or are they that, like, not knowing what's going on, just totally, like, discombobulated, like, in a freaking huge way? Because that's serious business. You're telling the world that the we're steaming towards Korea when you're in Australia. Amazing. Market-wise out here tomorrow, what you're going to be looking at, Big Blue is going to put some damage into the Dow tomorrow. Big Blue is trading at 163. You're at 170. ISRG will help the NDX 100. ISRG right now is trading at 782. It closed at 759. LRCX, Lam Research, that will also help the NDX 100. That's trading at 132, up $5 from 127. More than likely, let me see what AMAT's doing. Not that they come out with numbers. Yeah, AMAT's trading up too. So AMAT will trade up. That closed at 35. That's trading at 35. 45 RV. So these chips will, they'll start moving up again. KLA 10 core, let me see how that's. KLAC, KLA 10 core. Closed at 94.60, that's trading at 95. Bottom line is that, well, let's see, the SMHs. SMHs. Where is the SMH is closed at 77.39. That's trading 77.47. So there'll be some action there. Big Blue. So let's see what Big Blue has to say. Big Blue closed at 170. It's trading 163. IBM's revenue fell short of analysts' projections, marking the 20. Listen to this. This is amazing. Marking the 20th consecutive quarterly decline as growth in new businesses like cloud services and artificial intelligence failed to make up for the slumping legacy hardware and software sales. That sales miss, the first in more than a year, could temper estimates of a return of growth, revenue growth by early 2018. For years, Chief Executive Officer Ginni Romney has been investing in higher growth areas and moving away from older products like computers and operating systems software. Even as she shed units to cut cost, sales in the first quarter fell 2.8% from a year earlier to $18.2 billion, IBM said in a statement. That was a bigger drop than the 1.3% decline in the previous quarter. Analysts had expected $18.4 billion on average. The sales fell as much as 4%. Oh, the shares fell 4% to 163 in late trading. Bottom line is that you take a look at this, and what you're going to see, we're at 163.33. This topped out at 182 February 16th. And the last time we had any volume was the election, November 9th. And the top of that is 161. The gap is 155. And that's what it looks like it's going to go to. We bring this back, and what you're going to see, and this is where the real danger comes with IBM. IBM, its high is 215, which is in 2013. Went from 215 down to 116. It looks to me like this thing can go right back to 116 pretty easily. The first time down at 116, folks, what had saved it was the downdraft in October of 08. The high of that is 116.80, and that's monster volume. You know? So that's where we might consolidate out of. It certainly, when it rose higher, it was on anemic volume. It was coming into a monthly volume of 146 million, and we did 59 million. So that supply line right there is vicious. That the supply line on IBM goes from July of 2011 all the way over to October of 2014. That's a big number. That's a huge supply line. And in the case of IBM, what has happened, they still have a monster float out there. 943 million shares. It's a big number. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials finished down 113. NASDAQ off 7. S&P's down 6.5. We're going to be right back, folks.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. With over $56 million in cash and over $66 million in working capital, Great Panther Silver is positioned as a company with a solid foundation and poised for growth. While completely unhedged to the price of silver, Great Panther retains 100% ownership in 2 producing mines in Mexico, which is the top silver producing country in the world, along with future potential production in Peru. Great Panther is highly leveraged to the price of silver, and after a great year of performance in 2016, Great Panther Silver has a strong outlook for 2017 as well. With good liquidity in trading and strong fundamentals on the balance sheet, while remaining completely unhedged to the price of gold and silver, now is a perfect time to take a closer look at this equity. If you'd like to find out more about Great Panther Silver, then go to greatpanther.com or check them out on the NYSE market, symbol GPL, or the TSX, symbol GPR.
Join Andy Hecht as he shows you how to make money in commodities. The Commodities Hour, next on TFNN.
Welcome back, folks. And folks, don't forget, when you come over to our website at TFNN, you're going to see right on the front page, our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, who does a show every trading day right here, 11 o'clock to 12 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. He's doing a subscriber event Thursday night from 6 to 7:30. If you want to get in the subscriber event, all you have to do is come over, test drive his newsletter. So if you're in his newsletter right now, you're going to be in there for free. If you'd like to test drive it for 30 days, you come in the event. And what Basil's going to be talking about, folks, is this. What stocks should participate in the next part of this mega bull market's phase when this correction is complete? Bottom line, Basil does great work, great workshops. April 20th, 6 to 7:30 Eastern Standard Time. And don't forget, folks, that if you can't make this live, we do put it on your page. It's archived, and you get it for a full month. If we take a look at the market out here, what you're looking at is this. What's going to be really, well, let me see first off, UKX. I believe I might have the volume statistics right now from the FTSE. Okay, so I do. Okay, so check it out. The FTSE got blown apart today and on volume, folks. You did 1 billion shares, and you did, look at this, too. You're coming. Okay, so we're coming into the 31st, which is 1.042 billion, and we did 1.07 billion. So bottom line is that you broke the swing point, and, oh, actually, we haven't got to the swing point yet, 7099. We'll get to it tomorrow. So you're barreling into the swing point, which is 7099 with volume. The FTSE was down 2.5% today. It looks to me like the FTSE is going to get right into where this started off from. And where we started off from was the FTSE's case. They're talking about 6,911. That won't be too hard to get to. We went down a buck 80 today. The DAX in Germany, let's go take a look at the DAX in Germany. And our markets, by the way, folks, did not pay attention to what did happen in Europe today. And that in itself is divergence, because guess what? We're in a one-world market. DAX in Germany also came down with volume. We did 89 million shares. That broke the 84 million from the 11th of April. Now your next stop is down at 11,850. We're at 12,000. And looks the larger context on the DAX looks to me like you're going to get 11,451. Bottom line, what is that saying? That's saying that, number one, it's going to have more pressure tomorrow. If we go back to our own S&P, what you'll see, the RS&P today was really a flat market, folks. Down 70 cents, that's a flat market. That, however, being said, is building cause for lower price. You're going to at least try to test the low that was generated out here on the 27th. Dow Industrials look to me, the Dow is going to is the weakest indice in the Dow. The 27th is at, the high is 20,000. 578, we're already below that high. The low is 20,412. 412, IBM itself, if it stays down $7, will blow that number away. And what that would set up in the Dow is that that would set up a Dow 19,981. Because if you take a look at, let's just watch this. So inside the Dow today, what you had is that Goldman was the leader on the way down. But just so you can understand, when you get a large stock, how much it can bring it down. Well, Goldman put in 73 negative points of the 113 in the Dow Industrials. Now, of course, you take the negatives and you take the positives. The positive out here today was United Health that put in 9 points. The other big negative today was Johnson & Johnson. That was down 26. So you get, it's a large cap weighted index. And guess what? When you get IBM, that also is trading at a big number, 170, opens at 163. That also is going to put some real juice into the Dow downtown. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. Stay right there. Andy's coming right up. Wow! Go get him, folks.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you'll lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.